Hey everybody, hope you're all having a good day. It's pretty rainy down here, but I do have some new server stuff to make a new video. Now, the story on how I got this, because I always like to say the backstory, is that I have an ad on Kijiji, which is like a Craigslist kind of buy and sell thing in Canada here, and it's an ad just basically looking for old servers. Now, a guy about almost an hour or so away messaged me. He's like, oh, I have all these servers. You can have them all for $100. I said, okay, so let's take a look. There was a bunch that were nothing special, but I did notice a Dell PowerEdge 6450 and the PowerEdge 4400, which are both Pentium 3 Xeon machines. One holds two processors, and the other one holds four. Now, if you look in this video as well, you'll also see on the side a compact drive array full of drives and a compact little KVM keyboard, monitor, and video, whatever you call it there, switching device too. So I got basically, I think there were about eight servers or so. I kept two of them, which are in that server on the right there, which is kind of a custom machine, which I'll be going through, of course, in the video in a few. And I kept the drive array and the KVM, plus a bunch of other little bits and pieces too. Now, the other servers, they were, like I say, nothing really special, but I did end up parting them out and selling a bunch of the parts and also trading the scrap empty chassis and boards for a bunch of video cards, actually half a dozen older video cards, like 1 gig video memory or so, but still a pretty good deal. But anyway, today we're gonna go over this server. I'll show you, like usual, the hardware, the software, it running, and even I got some photos. I'll try to put together a little collage kind of thing of the custom job that I did to this machine, because it is fully custom, which I've never done before. So looking at the front of the machine here, you will see that it is actually fully intact. However, there are a few scuffs on it. Now, I'll get into this a little bit later in the video, but this machine here is actually a Dell PowerEdge 4400, as you can see by the badge. However, it has the Dell PowerEdge 6450 motherboard in it from the other computer. Now, like I say again, I'll be getting into this a bit later, but basically there is a 4400 and then also a 6400 PowerEdge, so they're more or less the same chassis from what I can find on the internet. However, the board has been swapped into this, and it's kind of confusing the way it works. But like I say, I'll get into that now. So if we look on the front, everything is intact. If we press this little button here and push that down, that opens up. Now you can see in here, the system is a little confusing to work with because it doesn't actually have IDE on it. So we have to use SCSI for basically anything. Now, luckily that SCSI CD-ROM at the top there still works, which is good because, like I say, you can't run IDE, so that works. It was a little tricky because I had to rewrite a bunch of my ISOs for a CD-ROM with a CD disk instead of a DVD disk, which was fun. But anyway, I got that. There's a floppy at the top there, and then there's also an Ultium LTO1 tape drive on there, which I think works. I don't know. I don't have any cassettes for that are LTO1. I have an LTO2 and an LTO3, but not an LTO1, so that's a lot of fun. Anyway, you'll also see here, this is the key for the front. Now, if you look right down here, that's the power button for the server to turn it on, and then we also have a lock. Now, I'll show you a cool feature of this server. If we close the door here, basically the security on the system, which is pretty cool, but also kind of weird, not really effective, is that if we look at the drives here, if we try to pull these drives out, the system is now currently locked, but if we try to pull the drives out, you'll see there's a metal bar here that stops you from removing those. So if we go to this, if we put our key in here now and unlock it, now the lock is a little weird on this. Kind of has its mind of its own. So if we go to unlock, and then it'll kind of fall back there. But if we go to unlock and then pull it, it works okay. If we unlock it, you'll see that that metal bar down here has actually removed, and now we can go and we can remove our drives from this server, which is really cool. That just prevents, I guess, people from messing around and just ripping the drives out of it when it's running, or even off, or from somebody stealing the drive. Oh geez, first time. That guy back in there. The drive caddies on this are pretty nice. They're easy to work with. They're not like the compact, the ones on the left there that you can see in the frame of the video with the lights that burn out on them all the time. These ones are, they have like a plastic bar that comes across in them. Now, there are eight drives in here. These four are set up as a RAID 0. These two are set up as a RAID 0, and these other two are set up as a RAID 0. So we'll go ahead here now. I'll show you this again when we'll lock our drive bays. Now, the lock is kind of useless on this because it doesn't prevent anybody from actually just opening up this door and pressing the power button and shutting off the server and or going into it and breaking everything, but it does stop from physically stealing the hard drives, which is kind of cool. So that's the front of the system. Now, I have had a couple of these, but usually when I find them, they're either broken or missing this door. So this one was intact. Like I say, there are a couple scuffs. I tried to buff them up a little bit. It's not perfect, but
yeah, it's intact, which is what matters.
So for this next one here, I'm going to have to freehand this just because of the way that the server is set up. Now, if we look here on the back left-hand side, you will see that there is a little door there on the back. Now, getting to that in just a second, if we look around the back of the server, you will see a few ports here, PS2 mouse and keyboard, two USB, a LAN, some serial ports, a video output there, and then as far as cards, we'll get to the cards in a second. There are also three power supplies, which the server will complain if you don't have all three installed. Now, back to this door here, if we open this up, this server actually has hot swap PCI, which if you see those little dots there on the right hand side, those are actually lights that I'll show you when it's running. They light up. Now you can press that button and actually remove the cards from the system when it is running. It's pretty cool. So as far as cards that I have installed in here, starting from the top, we have the red SATA cord. You can see cable, you can see that's a SIL SATA card, runs just a 160 gig drive. Then I have a gigabit PCI card in there, Sound Blaster Audio G2, then a fiber optic card, another fiber optic card, just a basic 10100 LAN, and then a PERC 2, I think PERC 2 DC, I don't know, a second gen PERC RAID card, which is SCSI with 128 megs of memory for the controller. So that's that there. I am just going to pause the video here and open up the side panel. Now, to open the side panel, close this guy first, and then basically all we do is just, it's super easy, we just turn this thing here and then this panel will slide off. Now I'm gonna stop the video because you need two hands to do that, so be right back. Alright, so I've undone this little screw here. Now to open the side, all we do is grab this and give it a pull there. Really easy to come off. Actually, I have to commend Dell for their design on that, which is very nice. So yeah, first thing we see when the server is open are these four massive processors here. Now these are Pentium 3 Xeon, 700 megahertz. Now from my research on the internet, it seems that this server's model is actually the PowerEdge 6400/700, which only came with 700 megahertz processors. Now I do have some 1000 megahertz processors, however they are 133 bus, these are 100 bus. And when I put them in the server, I had mixed results. They would boot, but then I had where processor A and processor D were showing, but unknown. And then they said 700 megahertz, and it wasn't reading these other ones, even though I had four. However, I have two that are one spec code, and the other two are a different spec code. So it's just not really that kind of a good idea. Anyway, so for 700 megahertz, that's what it came with. Now, if you look in here, the RAM is actually a card that slides into the board, and I'm not going to remove it. Well, when I put this card in here, if you look really closely, there are actually two screws, one here and one here. They are holding this card. If you see, I can press down on it there so it doesn't flex when the server's resting, because without it, it'll kind of flop down. Don't want that to happen. Same with the kind of riser things there that you call those for the video cards or for the long PCI cards in there. But yeah, so those, that's holding that in there. Now, as far as the RAM, this takes a, I'm trying to remember the name of it. I think it's an SD RAM kind of thing. It's 133 megahertz it runs. Now there are actually, I gotta count the slots, I believe there's 16 slots. Let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, yeah, two banks of 8 on each side. And as far as the RAM in here, this server can support a total of, I believe, 8 gigs of memory. Now I have 4 in here now. There are, you're gonna get me again, I think there's 8 sticks of 256 and 4 sticks of 512 RAM in there. Now I do only have 4 gigs just because that's basically, like, I'm not actually using this as a server. It's just for more playing around and goofing off. And like I say, 32-bit operating system, 4 gig is basically, you know, cap for that anyway. Even though Server 03, we can use more anyway. But yeah, 4 gigs of RAM, it's a nice amount, it runs good. So, to the top here, we have our 160 gig drive that I've just kind of bolted to the front, just to need somewhere to go. The server isn't meant to run with one of those, but yeah, it's a lot faster than the SCSI and a lot more reliable, I'll tell you that. So, but that's basically the inside of the system. It's pretty straightforward. You can see the board, the motherboard is massive. We have total, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 slots total. And this thing is just like, this whole thing is the board. It's just huge. Now, I will do I'm going to fade us into, hopefully with some nice instrumental music, a slideshow here of my process when I put this board into here. Now, when I did the board, I had the 64, and I'll get to the point where I was saying earlier, I had the 6450, which is a rack unit, which worked good, but I'm like, nah, this thing isn't really my thing. And then I had the 4400, which is this guy here, with the two processor, basically the same system, just dual processor, and it can only take 4 gigs of RAM, this one can take 8. So, had that, and then I'm like, okay, well, this, I was, whatever, brushing my teeth one night, and then I'm like, these boards look very similar, and then I compared all the pins. I wrote myself a diagram. If you look, there's actually three different power, you can't really see, but there's three different power connectors that the motherboard will take. Now, I compared the backplane, because the power supplies slide into a backplane and then they plug into the board. So I compared those and I'm like, these pins are all identical and they're the same. And I'm like, I wonder if this will work. This, I didn't even know about the 6400 tower. I just thought the 6450 was like the 8450, which is only a rack mount unit. So I swapped the boards out. Now they had this, the only real difference, all these screws fit in. It's really just like a tab. It's like a finger and then it just kind of slides into the board. That's all it is. Now, the only difference here is at the top. Now for the 4400 board with two processors, there's almost two big tabs on each of the processors. Now for this one, there's four big tabs on each of the processors. So there was eight tabs. So in order to modify this, I basically just had to cut those tabs off. And then the board has retaining clips at the top that hold it in. Now you can see it's a little, it's not rock solid in there, but it runs okay and I haven't had any issues with it. And it, like I say, it fits in perfectly. And then, like I say, I just put a couple bolts in here just to hold the RAM riser in, because on the 6450, it will slide in and it has almost like a little finger like this that hold it right on this little tab here on the side. So basically I've just made my own little connector for that. So, but yeah, that's it. That's basically the system. We'll go around back to the front and I'll fire it up for you. Alright, so this is going to be the first attempted, or hopefully working, power up of my SWAT system here with the 6450 board in the 4400 chassis. Now everything has been plugged in properly to the best of my knowledge. I got the fans and everything. It looks pretty much stock to the average person. The only thing I had to remove was this fan baffle here because it didn't fit with the RAM riser card, and it also only cools two processors. And it completely blocked off the fourth one. So hopefully that fan's enough to keep it cool. I don't know what's going to happen here. The machine's been all cleaned up. And one power supply and the keyboard and monitor is plugged in. So we're going to do this now. I really hope it doesn't like short circuit or something. We'll start with plugging in the screen. And then we're going to plug in the power. There we go. All right. So we have power now to the tower. Power to the tower. And I'm going to just come over here. My place is a total pigsty. And we're going to press this power button and see what happens. All right, here we go. All right, looks like we have power to some degree. Oh, and there we go. Look at that. 6400 PowerEdge. All right, so we're back at the front of the machine now. And I do have all three of the power supplies plugged in. And also my awesome ISA, or not ISA, what do you call it there? A 5-pin keyboard that I've converted to PS2, and then just a USB mouse. So the compact drive array absolutely isn't plugged in. That's going to be for a different video. But yeah, basically the computer will complain. We'll have an error light if we only have one or two power supplies plugged in. It's like, oh, redundancy, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, we're going to fire it up here. So I'm just going to press the power button, and I'll walk you through the post of how it runs. Now, the computer's actually pretty quiet, I have to say. It's not, it doesn't do anything like the compacts where it runs at like Mach 10 until the software kicks in and anything. You can talk over it fairly easily, I have to say. It's a big bear. It runs good. So, all right, so here's the post screen for the Dell. Now you'll see it identifies the system as a 6400/700, even though it was 6450 board. I don't know how it really works, but at first I thought there was a BIOS for the 6400 and the 700, which is a completely different system with a single Pentium 4. Anyway, it's booting up there now. You'll see the server firmware versions load in. I did update those. At first I would get a message that would complain about the different firmwares. It'd say, oh, they're out of date or whatever. It seems to work okay, even though that power supply one is version 2, so it's a different system. Anyway, you'll see it detects four processors and our SATA RAID card with the 160 gig drive in there. SIL concatenation, whatever the heck that is. I don't know what that word even means, but I'm guessing drive. Anyway, there's our DAVTEC. This is our SCSI card here. It's going to load our CD-ROM. There you go. And the tape drive, as you can see, loaded in there. And if you have a bootable drive, it will actually say bootable drive ready kind of thing. Anyway, here's our Emulex. Now I have a fiber optic host card and also an internet adapter card. I don't know which one that is. And now we're on to our PERC 2. I believe it's a PERC 2 DC. We'll see in the, when it's done here. It's reading our drives. The drives are all spooled up as we just saw there before. Oh my god, I don't know why this thing has like a freaking issue with like staying focused. Like, there you go. Then we have our three drives plugged in. And there's our Broadcom Gigabit Ethernet, which I'll be using for our test later. Oh, there's my skinhead in the screen. Hello. Wow, that screen is dirty. Look how dirty. I think, you know what? I think the last time I made a video, I was going to clean that too, and I never did. Good job. Oh, there's my little arm. Oh, yeah. That's going to load Windows Server 2003 in just a second here. There we go. Look at that. Looking to see if it's focused again. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to grab our mouse and keyboard and just bring them off screen here. Hopefully not in the video. Just bring those out of the way so that you can see what's going on. I'm also going to keep an eye on this just in case it falls over or does something stupid. Getting some pretty good reflection off the window. I think I might... Oh, there we go. Like, I could just stay focused. Like, I don't know... Like, I'm just recording on my phone now. It has a pretty good camera. Like, it's 1920 by 1080 or whatever. And I have, like, literally an office chair just as the bipod, tripod, whatever you call it. More like an octopod because it has, like, eight legs. But but I like that. Actually, you know, 1, 2, 3, 5. So is a pentapod? Is that even a thing? I don't know. Anyway, weird chat while the Windows loads. But if it could just stay focused on the screen, I don't know what its problem is. It looks like it's doing pretty good here now. But anyway, we're on the login now, so I have a few users made, but basically myself, Dom, and the password is a top secret 123. So we'll load into Windows now, and you can see it loads pretty quick. Like, this is just a 160 gig SATA drive, not in RAID on that SIL controller on PCI, and it booted right away into Windows. Like, we're already on the main screen now. If we start by looking, hopefully you can see this okay. Looks like it's in my frame. Okay, so we have down here at the bottom, you'll see I have my four Ethernets. They are not plugged in. There's the volume for our sound card. Now, I am going to plug in a little set of laptop speakers in a minute here. And this is our control suite for the either the Ethernet. I believe it's the Ethernet or the SIL SATA. I believe it's the Ethernet. It doesn't actually do anything. There we go. It just basically tells us. Now, I don't know why, but this 1394 adapter always says that it's plugged in. I really don't know why that is. Anyway, one thing that I like to do right away is open up Task Manager and actually go to Processes or Performance there. And you can see that there are four processors running. Now, these are not threaded or whatever, quad core or whatever, i3. These are four physical processors. Now, you do have to use a server operating system, which you can see I've enabled themes and I've enabled all this other crap to make it look like Windows XP. Basically, it's just like a server 03 kernel with a Windows XP kind of pasted, slapped onto it like a pancake on the front. So I'll keep, what I'll do is I'll shrink this down, but you'll actually see in the bottom here, this is our CPU usage. And like I say, as it uses more, which you'll see later, it will fill up solid green as I do more stuff. So now, as far as the programs that are on here, we have our basic stuff. We'll go to, where is it? We'll go to control panel here first. I'll walk you through the hardware on it. Go into system. So you'll see here, Dom's Electronics is registered to me with my little activator. Pentium 3 Xeon processor, 700 megahertz, 3.87 gigs of RAM. If we go into our device manager, everything's installed. It works perfect because this is like meant for 03 server. I did have server 08 installed onto it, which ran okay. I'm not going to complain about how it ran. However, there was no drivers. I couldn't find anything for drivers. It was just like, I like to run a newer server OS. Now, the problem is that with my other servers, usually they're dual processor. Now, this one is quad, so if I use Windows 7, which will work okay, is that I only use two processors out of four, which is completely useless. So, yeah, we have to use Server 03 for this. I wanted to use a newer server, Server 2008 Service Pack 2, not R2. R2 is only 64, but it was a hassle. Like I say, I got the whatever 08 server on it, and it's just ran like shit. So, excuse my language. Anyway, so we'll go through it here now. You'll see our disk drives. Oh, blooper. Our disk drives. So we have our three. Those are our SCSI PERC drives, and then here's our Silicon Image SATA drive. As far as our display adapters, we have a blisteringly fast ATI Radeon 3D Rage 2 with 4 megs of memory. Oh my god, hold on to your hats for that one. Basic whatever, floppy, blah blah blah, this, that, the other. Go to our network adapters here. Let me make this full screen. Doesn't really do any difference, but there we go. We have our 1394 net adapter, our gigabit Ethernet adapter. Holy moly there. Another PCI, that's a little Dell one. Pro 100, and then our Pro 1000 fiber F, you can see there, the F server adapter, which is pretty funky and cool, even though I've never used it. And then here's our four processors, which somehow the system detects they're Pentium 3 Xeon. In here, they just say processor. That's all we get. But yeah, that's that. And then we have our two Adaptex SCSI cards that control our tape drive. There's our PERC, I actually have it, PERC 2 DC RAID controller, because I couldn't remember what it was. And then there's our Emulex LP9000. That's a fiber channel host adapter. So I believe that one you can actually plug a fiber optic connection into. Now, I'm hopefully at my new house that I'm buying, I will have fiber optic so I can plug it into this. I don't know if that's how that works. Anyway, we're on to our SATA controller there. That's that. Very easy, simple install with that. Just a floppy F6 driver at the start. And then here we have our audio stuff. So we have our Sound Blaster Audio, so we actually have sound on the server once it's enabled, and our tape drive, which is our Altrium LT01. I also tried to install USB on this. Now you'll see we have a grand total of two USB ports on here. Well, I guess one, because one's open, but there is two total. One is this mouse that I'm using, and then the other one I will plug a USB flash drive. Now the transfer speed is very slow. I did try to use my Wi-Fi USB adapter, but it's USB 3, and I don't know if this is actually compatible with USB 3 devices on USB 1. I don't know. It didn't work. It didn't want to install. It would show a 802.11 Wi-Fi adapter, but it wasn't doing crap all. I even installed the driver, and it like wasn't having it, so... Anyway, for our test later, I'm going to plug in my laptop with the Ethernet to the gigabit. Anyway, that's that there. That's the system. Whatever. We'll do. I'll show you here real quick the screen resolution. So 124 by 768. It does have another setting. It does have two actually more settings, but these don't work for whatever reason. I like 1024. Like I say, for Windows XP, I do like the older kind of, reminds me of my childhood, like kind of big display. It's pretty cool. 32-bit color. Like I say, it works okay. You don't get anything for 3D. But this, like I say, as far as a desktop performance for the server OS, it's very good. Like I say, compared to some of the other cards, like those S3 Verge and stuff, which are just like abysmal, like this card is pretty good. Now, what's weird is that it's actually an AGP chip, but it says it's PCI. So I don't know, I guess maybe they use this on AGP and PCI, but like I say, 4 megs, it works pretty good. Like I don't have any sort of, you can move stuff around here. You don't have any sort of issues. Now I will show you this real quick too, even just for fun, like a little bit of rendering. Like this is 3D, whatever, and it's, the 3D pipes is okay. Like 3D pipes doesn't have a problem, so I don't know why it complains about stuff like that. But I'll just do a focus here for you. Oh my god, this thing is just like so stupid. Is that focused? No, that's not focused. I don't know why. Like just it doesn't change. Like I'm not running around. Just change. Stay focused on the screen. Like why is your problem there? Is that focused? I don't know. Whatever. Let's keep it there. Anyway. That's that. Now we also have our... Actually, let's check this really quick. Activate Windows. Now, this works great for Windows XP, but for this server 03, it doesn't seem to be working. Now, it says activate. I have this thing called WPA Kill. It's like a program that tricks Explorer into thinking that it's activated or running in safe mode. And then it, yeah, boots into that and supposedly works. Like I say, it works great for XP. For this, I don't know. I'm pretty sure I used it on this before and it didn't actually work, but we'll see. Okay, that's focused there now. So let me show you the Dell Server Administrator. Now, this is basically like that Compaq software from the Compaq servers, if you've ever watched any of my videos, but I actually like this one more. It works a lot better, honestly, in my opinion. So what I'm gonna do is just make sure that's focused down there. There we go. Okay, so now for our login, that's me. Again, top secret password, 123. So now when we're in here, this is like, this basically tells us every single thing about the server, and this software is very, very good. Like, to get it installed, I'm surprised how easy it was. It's literally just run a program. Unlike if you've watched a video of my ProLiance there, especially the 7000, getting the software on the Compaq was just like beyond brutal and just a huge pain in the ass, and I couldn't figure it out. This thing, all I did was run it installed and log in as an admin, and I'm like, oh, I can view and do everything. So we got this here now. So basically, if there's any sort of errors, these are the kind of the main three parts of the server here. Now, if you have three power supplies like I do, and then only a couple plugged in or one plugged in, you'll get an issue. Like these will light up and then you'll have that front light blinking, which mine are not. Everything's green now for the time being. It's all good. So basically we can click through here and then go through the different aspects of the server, I guess you could say. Like I say, everything, this will show you every single thing of the computer. It's hilarious. There's our BIOS version. These are our currents, like our voltage currents for, like I say, power supply, powers, like all the voltage for that, even the fans, like the reading at the time. And you also get the minimum and maximum, because like I say, I've heard stories about people running
slower fans in these, because the noise isn't bad, but you know, if it's sitting beside you, it can get a little noisy. I mean, those SCSI drives are the noisiest, but like I say, this doesn't update. You have to refresh it. It has somewhere a thing for refresh somewhere. There it is. So it doesn't update in real time, but it will give you a reading at the time of clicking it. So, I mean, that's pretty good for 2001. I mean, these are our firmwares. We have our intrusion. That's the switch, which I've actually taped the switch shut so that doesn't go off, because it's a pain in my ass. As far as that, this is the memory here. Like I say, it tells us all our memory. It tells us all the things that are plugged in. So you can see I have four sticks of 256, four 512s, and another four of 256 there. Here's our network thing. It tells us our four different adapters there, our different ports and what's plugged in. There you go, serial, mouse, keyboard, USB, all that stuff. Here's our three power supplies. They're maximum wattage, 320 watts. If they're online, if they're okay. Full redundancy, thank you. I'm using three things plugged into the wall. Don't even get me started. Our four processors, Pentium 3 Xeon, tells us our model, our stepping, that our speed, 700 megahertz, and the clock speed, or the bus speed, which is 100 megahertz. And this is pretty cool too. This will show us all of the slots on the computer and they're in use. Also their bus width and what location they are. PCI 2.1-7. And then also the embedded. So you can see here, those are all the cards I talked about earlier. If you're really interested in those, you can pause the video and take a look. I've gone over them already. And then also our temperatures here. Everything is good. Like I say, you also get the minimum and maximum threshold, which is really cool. And then the failure threshold too, which is when you can actually set the computer to shut down like a thermal error. Unlike the Compaq, you can actually disable this, which I've done because I'm not worried about the thermals. The Compaq will just be like, hey, screw you, it's too hot, bye, and shut off. This you can set it to beep or complain or light up or whatever you want to do. And then, yeah, these are more voltages here for everything. If we go into our software, this will just tell us about our operating system here. It says that I have Windows Server 03 Enterprise Edition, the different build, whatever, blah, blah, when you do it, time that you booted it up, all the things that are installed, all the management, kind of like Compaq, the management agents sort of thing. And then our last thing in here is actually the the storage section. So we have a couple things plugged in. This is our Adaptec PC160. Are two different channels. Now, I'm not going to bother clicking on these. They don't do anything. I don't even think they tell you that you have a tape drive installed, which would kind of make sense. I don't know why it doesn't. Actually, let's click on it and see. Last time I was in here, I don't think it did that, though. And it doesn't even say what it has, which is kind of dumb. But if we go to the Perk 2 here, this will tell us everything about it. Now, it'll show us our battery, which is kind of strange. It says ready, recharge 0, max recharge 1100. And this never changes, so it's like an invincible battery. It never charges or can run out. We can click on our channel zero, our black plane, and then our array disk. Now, this is really cool. This is like the Compaq's disk manager, whatever you call it. Now, everything's built into this Dell, which is totally awesome. Works like way better. I really like it. So this will show us all of our array disks here. 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, and 9, because, you know, why would we rename them in like a sequence? Now we'll give them weird names. Anyway, so these will show us our disk, and then we can also, available tasks, we can also blink the lights. Now I will show you that, but I will show you that with the array viewer thing. Come on, I'm trying to make this a little bigger here. There we go. So if we go down here to virtual disks, again, we have also the other channel, which has nothing, and the firmware driver. Now, if you look here, we'll see our virtual disk 0, 1, and 2. Now, if we look, let me try to move this here and try not to screw up my video. Oh, that was slick. That was slick. So if we look at our disks here, I'm going to go on our virtual disk manager here and select virtual disk 0 to blink. And then I'm going to hit execute. And then you'll see there, it starts to blink. So it lets us know which disk we're running. So it also has a feature called unblink, which I'll do that. And then, wow, look at that. It shuts off. So we can go to even virtual disk 1 and click that. And then that also will blink too, which is a cool feature. Lets you know where the virtual disk is. Now, that's basically that for this software here. Like I say, that's all the features of that, and that's basically all you really get with the Dell, is this one program that has everything built into it, which is really cool. So now I'm going to stop our video here, and I'm going to plug in my laptop to the Ethernet port, and we're going to do some tests on the internet and stuff. Be right back. All right, so now I've got my internet plugged in to my laptop, because I wanted to use a Wi-Fi for this, but the Wi-Fi was not having it. So we just have the gigabit PCI network card from the server plugged into the laptop's Ethernet port, and we're sharing that. And I've also plugged in a USB speaker to the Dell for some sound. So First thing we're gonna do here is play a song for you just to show that this works. We're gonna play this Beck song for you. Now, you'll notice that, I'll put it at full. At first I was getting some distortion with the volume, but I did go into the creative control panel down here and adjust a couple things, and it's working pretty good now. So you'll hear that it's playing nicely. We don't have any distortion. We don't have anything really bad going on. If we go into, this is funny, this made me laugh at the start. If we go into the virtualizations and into, whatever, let's just do this one. You'll notice that it actually is a little bit, it's a little bit laggy there with the virtualization. And even the mouse, like I say, this video card is not meant to do this kind of thing. So it's not really doing too much there. But if we turn that off, it's okay. And then you also have the little shrinky dink, whatever here, which works really good. Now, again, I will remind, this is the CPU meter, so keep an eye on this as we do our test here, because this will show us basically what's running. Like I say, they're only at 4%, so it's only 4% of the CPU has been used to run that song. So let me open this back up here. I don't know how the heck do I do this. Hello. I can't see it. Oh my god. Okay, you know what? Fine, stay there. Part of the test. I don't know why it's green. Anyway, so we're going to go on the internet now. I did install an older version of Firefox. I did have to do a bit of research on this, and I believe this is Firefox 4.8 point something. Newer versions will complain because this processor doesn't have SSE or something, whatever, instructions, which is kind of really stupid. I don't know why. Anyway, I guess can you like get out of here? Oh, there we go. Bye. Okay, so first test. Let's go to YouTube. Now, a little bit of a spoiler alert, no spoiler alert, oh my god, look at that. So let's go to here, you can see it was already on this, so let's just go to YouTube and I'll show you what happens here now. This is an instructional video. We're going to see what happens when you try to access 2021 YouTube with a computer from 1999, so here we go. Yeah, basically that. You got the six windows there. Now, I want to say, though, as we notice, is that keep an eye on the processor speed here. This isn't any sort of thing that we come across with a problem. Isn't due to the computer. It's actually due just to software incompatibility. Right now, we have unsupported script. We're going to stop this. Spoiler alert, this will not work. This doesn't do anything. If we go to YouTube, this doesn't work. For some reason, these stupid developers now, they run so much shit on their websites that there's just all these dumb scripts and stuff. It doesn't work. So what we'll do here is we'll actually go. I was doing this earlier. I just typed in Google. Oh my god, freaking focus, man. I'm going to throw you out the window. I Googled literally YouTube video and this Miley Cyrus one popped up. And I'm like, okay, what if I just click directly to a YouTube video? Like, say your friend was like, oh, hey, check out this video. And you're like, okay, let me open it. So I'm going to show you this now. We're going to go right to this YouTube video. Again, you can see our processor's like barely like, yeah, whatever, 35%, which isn't a lot considering, like I say, what's being used. You can see how awful this runs. Now, here we are at our video now. Oh, look at that. Surprisingly, it plays an ad. Wow. So if we do stop script on this, it breaks. Oh, hold on. Never mind. It used to break. But of course YouTube will have literally nothing on the screen but a fucking ad. Excuse my language. Can I skip this? There we go. And there we go. That's our video running. Now you can see we don't have anything else. The script is all that stuff on this side here. Our videos, our comments, our likes. We have nothing on this. Like I say, I don't know if this is because of the browser or because of the script or whatever. You can see our processor here. He's getting a little bit excited. He's pushing 80, what is that, 80%, I think? Our processor is getting a bit excited there. But like I say, it's running, and this is in, let's see, can we even change the setting on this? Hello, what's that, 360p? Oh yeah, suggested. You see that slide in there? It was like drawing it in by hand. 360, and like I say, the audio works. It's not distorted. Like I say, you can shrink this down here. Oops, where'd Task Manager go? It was nice, casual 100%. Like I said, you can shrink that down, and now that it's buffered, you're only using a third of your processor, a third to half of your processor for that. Like, not a lot. Like, you're more than capable of going into here. Like I say, we can go into the computer. Oh, let's take a look. You know, I just gotta go in here and edit these game files. Like this works perfectly fine. There's no slowdowns. There's no lag. We can go in here. We can open up a texture file. Like I say, this is more than capable to multitask. Like I say, all this open, our processor's like still 44%, 51%. Like, it's not getting slowed down. This works perfectly fine. If any sort of problems arise, they're because of the incompatibilities with this web browser. Now, we're going to keep this running just for a real test. I don't know if this is going to work. I've never done this, but we're going to go to Facebook here now. And I think I've got my friend's account running on here just for fun. Yes, it is. It's my friend's account. So this isn't actually my Facebook account, but it's okay. Like, it works. So that's him there. Ram and Deep, shout out if you're watching this. I doubt it. But yeah, basically I have a friend who never uses his Facebook that he lends me for this. We basically use it for testing and developing. It's him, but like he has like no friends on it. Anyway, long story short, we do have an unsupported browser thing here, but like I say, what it says actually is we've redirected you to a simpler version to give you the best experience. Now, this is a throwback for us guys who are older and remember the older Facebook that was simpler, which I actually like this. Like I say, it works okay. We can scroll through here. We can like this random thing that's in Iranian or whatever language that is. I don't know. Like I say, and we're listening to YouTube video on the other tab. Now, this is pretty good. Like I say, these are both current. Like I say, this is current date. This wasn't recorded like earlier or something. Like, this is, hello. Wait, double click it. There you go. 3/21 on the whatever, July 2021. I'm old. Like I say, this works fine. Like, I'm scrolling through this. I'm not having any issues. Our CPU is high, 80% again. But like I say, this works okay. We're not having problems at all with anything. Like, it's working okay. Like, I'm gonna go even cute girl and you. We're gonna even add you on this fake account. There we go. We even sent a friend request on it with my buddy's fake not working but working thing. This is hilarious. I don't even know how he gets all these people. It's a friend of mine from college. There we go. So that's that. We'll close down these tabs now because our Miley Cyrus video is ending. But that's really about it. Like I say, this will, you can see there, like, it was on the internet perfectly fine. It was on Facebook, and it was even YouTube, broken YouTube and kind of broken Facebook, but running fine. Like, I mean, if for some really weird reason you had only this computer to use, you could be more than capable of going on the internet and using it. Like I say, it works great. You got decent amount of storage. You got decent amount of power. It's slower, like I say, you're using an older operating system, but like I say, does it pass my tests? I would say so. Like I say, it works. It works very good. Like I say, though, and the killer thing with that is that this system is, like, literally was made in 1999. Now, it was in service till about 2001 or so. Like I say, it's been updated. Like, it is a very higher-end system for 1999. Like, probably, well, I mean, the 8450 was the fastest Dell you could get. So this one is just, like I say, the 44 with the 6450 board. So it's basically one model under the highest system you could get in that 99-2000 kind of year. Anyway, but I mean, still, being 20 years old and what I paid for it, which basically cost me, it basically made me money once I sell the parts out of the other ones. But like I say, it works good. And it's a cool system, like I say. I like it, but...
Oh, I almost forgot the last step of the video. The most important part is that to shut down our system with that awesome noise that the SCSI drives make. And I just wanted to add something too. If you look on the bottom of the server, you'll see that it has blue casters. Now, those aren't original. I actually bought those to install. Now, from what I found on Google, this server came with kind of like a feet, and it also came with wheels, but I didn't have any luck actually finding OEM wheel set for it. Now, like I say, I just went to Princess Auto, which is a hardware store, and just bought four casters for literally like $10 or $15, and then just they kind of had some screws that sort of lined up, but I also drilled holes and tapped for like a whatever 1032 bolt and just put them on there. Like I say, it's pretty heavy. You can see it actually is indenting my carpet. The server weighs probably, I can pick it up, but it's pretty heavy. It's more bulky than anything. I'd say it weighs around 110, 120 pounds maybe or so. Like, basically the limit of what I would want to like pick up and carry around. But with those wheels, it's just a dream to move around. But anyway, like I say, that's the video. I forgot to add in my little shutdown here. So here we go. It always asks me for, you can't see it, but it says, oh, why'd you shut down the computer? So I'm going to say end of video. And we're going to click OK. Now listen to that awesome noise of those SCSI drives spooling down. And I hope you guys have a great day. And that's that. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And like I say again, have a great day.